Welcome to this video. In this video I will talk about tropical sprue. So I've given this picture of intestine and the bacteria. So what it means by tropical sprue is, tropical means it occurs in tropical region, okay? It affects the small intestine and it occurs because of the bacterial overgrowth, which leads to damage to the lining of the small intestine and which affects the absorption, which leads to malabsorption. So this is in nutshell what is tropical sprue. Let's talk about tropical sprue in detail. So this is a chronic progressive malabsorption in patients living in tropical regions, right? So mostly affects the Asian population. What are the causes? Causes increased bacterial overgrowth in the small bowel. Which are the bacteria that undergo overgrowth is E. coli, Enterobacter and Klebsiella. Okay, so what happens is, this is the normal columnar epithelial cells of the small intestine in which it has a villi. Okay, this finger like projection is the villi. This is needed for the absorption of the food that we take. Okay, now this bacteria overgrows, okay, and this causes inflammation in the small bowel and this will lead to damage of the epithelium. So this, what happens to this cell is, there is a blunting of the villi and so there will be decreased absorption of the food, right? So what happens is, this leads to malabsorption. So what are the symptoms patient will have? Patient will have abdominal distension, pain, diarrhea. Now because of malabsorption, there will be deficiency of essential vitamins, okay, megaloblastic anemia, protein absorption will also be affected. There will be ankle edema, glossitis, stomatitis. Gradually patient will become weak, he will experience fatigue, and all this affects his socioeconomic life. Okay, so this develops gradually, but this is a very severe disease, okay, and it has a remissions and relapses. Okay, so patient, what I mean by this is, patient will have like diarrhea, abdominal distension symptoms, then after taking treatment patient will be normal, then again due to some environmental issues, okay, because of the changes in the food or the place, okay, again when the patient exposes to that kind of environment, then again there will be increased bacterial growth and again patient will experience diarrhea and abdominal distension and all the symptoms. So this is remission and relapses. Okay, so how we diagnose this in the patient of the malabsorption? We take jejunal biopsy, and what we see in jejunal biopsy is the blunting of the villi, but this blunting of the villi is also seen in celiac disease. So it is difficult to differentiate between celiac disease and tropical sprue. Okay, basically celiac disease is the immune enteropathy, okay, there is a gluten hypersensitivity, and tropical sprue is the environmental enteropathy. It occurs because of the a tropical environment. Okay, in tropical environment there is, because of the kind of the environment and the food that the people take in this region, there is this leads to bacterial overgrowth, okay, because food is contaminated and there is bacterial overgrowth in the small bowel, which leads to the disease. And here, because of the gluten, there is a hypersensitivity and antibodies are formed which destroys the villi of the small intestine. Okay, so how to differentiate this is, we need to give a patient after the jejunal biopsy, we need to give the patient a gluten free diet. If the patient responds, then this is a celiac disease. Okay, and then again we need to do jejunal biopsy will be normal, this will be then we can diagnose this is the celiac disease. In tropical sprue, even after stopping gluten from the diet, the patient will not improve, okay, and no changes in the jejunal biopsy. So in this way we can diagnose that this is the topical sprue, and also we can have a presumptive diagnosis by taking patient's dietary history and the place from where he comes. Okay, if the patient is from the tropical areas, then we should keep this tropical sprue in our diagnosis. So how we can treat this patient? We need to give this patient tetracycline. Okay, by giving tetracycline, it will decrease the bacterial growth and thus gradually the small intestinal cells will regenerate and the symptoms will be resolved. Okay, so yeah, that's all for this video.